discuss about this concept introduced into chemical bonding. So hope you people have a greater knowledge of this, right? So hello, come across chemical bonding chapter. Agidiya nimge ellarigu. Have people any idea about chemical bonding? Or is this a new concept to you people? Okay, I believe you people have an idea about this chemical bonding. Already people have an idea. And you know what is chemical bonding and what all of sort of bonding takes place here. Okay. So before we get into know what is chemical bonding, so we have already studied Dalton's theory, right? So we have come across Dalton's theory. So in that Dalton's theory, what he says, so he says atom is the smallest particle, you know that. So he says what atom we have, that atom is going to be smallest particle. And also, we all know that atom has no independent existence. So these are the things which we know, right? So atom is the smallest particle and atom has no independent existence. So atom, or it has to, the atom has to combine so as to combine with the same or different type of atom, same or different type of atom to attain stability. So this is what we already know. So these two things we already know, right? So atom is going to be smallest particle and atom has no independent existence. And atom, if it wants to attain the stability, it has to combine with same type, or it has to combine with a different type of atom to attain the stability. And even over all this, we also know that every atom always tries to attain stability. Right? So every atom tries to attain stability. So if in that case, if every atom wants to combine, and if every atom wants to attain the stability, so how these atoms are going to combine and what all the criteria these atoms do follow to attain the stability. So this arises, this combination of two different atoms or different same atoms, when these two atoms, you can take it as a two atoms or more than that. So when they want to combine to attain the stability, or when they want to attain the inert gas configuration, so at that time they are going to form a bond here. So this bond is nothing but attraction. So we can define bond simply as attraction. So bond is going to be an attraction. So this attraction is between whom? This attraction is going to be between two particles. That particle can be an atom. So between those two atoms, if they exert an attraction, they start to combine. When they combine, they form a bond. So this formation of bond can be possible in three different ways. So as we know, it can be formed either by losing an electron or gaining an electron or the next one?
Sharing.
Yes. Sharing an electron. So in these three ways, it can form bond. Is there any other possible way where it can form a bond?
No, sir.
Yes. So, if the more possibilities irutte between any atom, when they combine to form a bond. So, either by losing, gaining, sharing an electron. Yav electron na share madbeku? That is very important again. Which electron it can share, whether it can share ultimate, penultimate or anti-penultimate. Last electron, valence shell alironta electron, what we have, only that electron it can share, it can gain to that valence electron or it can lose the electron from that position. Okay, so there are all the things which we already know. So now we'll see what is chemical bond is. Okay, so as I was saying, chemical bond is nothing but they are saying mutual electrical attraction between the nuclei and valence electron of different atoms that bind the atoms together. Okay. So this is going to be a mutual electrical attraction. We can also say this as and also can also call it as a type of intermolecular or inter-ionic attraction, type of intermolecular or interionic attraction which holds the two constituent atoms you can take together. So either of the way we can define the chemical bond. So intermolecular or interionic attraction. Attraction may be between the molecules or attraction may be between the ions, which holds the two constant atoms together. So here the atoms in the adana onde kadage hold maadi ittukobeku ottige hold maadi ittukobeku. So hold down and it go back on the, we need the attraction to be existing. So such type of attraction, we call it as a chemical bond. So there's a kind of force also you can call. One force of attraction in the, so other than the atoms in the, they're going to bond or they're going to held together very closely. So here the mutual electrical attraction between nuclei and valence electron of different atoms. different atoms that binds the atom together. So nuclei matte valence electron obviously gottide nucleus en irutade it will be having a positive charge and electrons en irutade negative charge. So avaru madhi already exist aagirutade attraction. Okay, so ee attraction en aagtide of different atoms that binds the atom together. So ee tara en ond attraction bere atom galallo exist aagutte aa reetiyada attraction when they come closer then the attraction there will exist. So avaga aa case alli aa attraction exist aagi then they will start to form a bond. So valence electron which is already known outermost electron that are available to be lost, gained or shared to form a chemical bond as I told in the beginning. Okay, so that is what chemical bond. Moving on to next, you can see here a force that holds a group of two or more atoms together and makes them function as a unit. Okay, so force that holds group of two or more atoms together. So two or more adakinte jaasti atoms na ond force of attraction ira na hold mari onde unit agi ond function madange iga hydrogen bere atom oxygen bere atom avaredna hold mari ond force of ಅದು ಒಂದೇ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿನ ತೋರಿಸಂಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಂಗೆ ಈ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಡಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆಟಮ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ನೋ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋವಲೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಶಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ a force that holds group of two or more atoms together and makes them as a function as unit. So ella en atom galna serisi so avu atom galu combine aakinta munche property vera irutte. So when they combine then the property is going to be changed. So they will make it to do the same one single function or it has to work as a one single unit. And moving on to the next thing is the types of chemical bonds we have. So we all know different types of chemical bond. So in that we have ionic bond, covalent bond, okay, so ionic bond, covalent bond with this. Then our coordinate covalent bond. Coordinate covalent bond and so with respect to ionic bonding, covalent bonding and other three we have coordinate covalent bond and metallic bond and hydrogen bond. So these are totally five types of bonds we have: ionic bonding, covalent bonding, coordinate covalent, metallic and hydrogen bond. So these are the five different types of chemical bonds in which these five are the most common type of bond that will exist between any two constituent atoms. This is going to be the very most common. Common anakinta elladralu maximum 95% ide exist agutha. And these kind of five bonds are going to exist. There is no other kind of bonds are very rarely seen, but these five are very major, and these five are going to be most common type of bonds between any two constituent atoms. Okay, so if I take ionic bond, so their ionic bond is going to be between a metal and a non-metal. Okay, so we can remember that easily. The bond is between a metal and a non-metal. Then the bond between them is going to be an ionic bond. Okay, so and coming to the covalent bond, so covalent bond is going to be existing between non-metal. So the covalent bond will exist between non-metal. Okay, so there the covalent bond is going to be existing between non-metals, and again metallic bond, I don't need to sell anything, it is going to be only between the metals. So we'll see what is coordinate and covalent. So coordinate covalent bond, so coordinate covalent bond is nothing but it is a same like that of covalent bonding. So coordinate covalent bond is in that covalent bonding tarane share madutallude. Okay, but what is the one small difference between coordinate covalent and covalent bonding is we know that in covalent bonding each atom will share the electron. So here this atom is sharing one electron and here this atom is sharing one electron. Okay, so they both are going to share and they'll form a bond here. But when it comes to coordinate covalent bond, only one atom is going to share both the electrons. Okay, so it will share both the electrons, and we know one bond, one single bond consists of two electrons. Do you all know that? One single bond consists of two electrons. It is made up of two electrons. One single bond is made up of two electrons. So here, in the case of coordinate covalent bond, these two electrons are going to be shared by a single atom. Okay, in covalent bond, both atoms going to contribute same number of electrons to the bond. But in coordinate bond, two electrons are donated by single atom. One single atom in the yellow coordinate bond gonna donate matter, which we have already seen in the case of NH4+. Okay, so this is ammonia. And ammonia will have lone pair of electrons, and we have an H+ ion here. So this nitrogen, the electrons will be donated to hydrogen, which is in the form of H+. So H+ is nothing but it needs electron. So to this, the electrons are given by nitrogen. Complete two electrons. All these two electrons is given to nitrogen. Okay, so this can also I can write. So here I am showing a arrow mark. That arrow mark indicates which atom has given the electron to which one. So coordinate covalent bond should be represented in this manner only. So in other cases we are going to have we are going to write the single bond without no arrow marks. But in the case of coordinate covalent bond, we are going to indicate the arrow mark, where that arrow mark indicates from where the electron is transferred to which atom, from which atom to which atom electrons are transferred. So that is going to be indicated by coordinate covalent bond.
Does it only share with non-metals?
Yes, it is going to have a bond. Andre ade covalent bonding tarane idu ond irodrinda it is also going to happen between non-metals only, because it's a kind of covalent bond. So it will happen between non-metals only. Okay, so that is about the coordinate covalent bond, and I'll tell what is hydrogen bonding in the next two slides. Okay, so yeah, this is much what I have discussed up to now. Is that clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll explain what is ionic bond and what is covalent bond. Everything we already know that things. Already have studied. It will just be fun. So as I was saying, the bond between metal and non-metal. The bond which is between metal and non-metal is going to be which type of bond?
Ionic bond.
It is going to be ionic. If the bond between two non-metals,
covalent bond.
Covalent bond. Yes. If the bond is between two metals or more than two metals,
metallic.
Metallic bond.
Metallic. Yes, absolutely. So, before moving on to know what is ionic bond or what is covalent bond, so we'll discuss about bond energy. So, can anyone say me what is, or anyone tell me what is bond energy? Anyone have an idea? Whatever idea you have, you can share that. What is bond energy?
Strongness of a bond.
Okay. Good.
Attractive force between
two atoms. Okay.
Two atoms.
Energy of an electron.
Okay. Energy of two electrons I can take.
Strength of the bond.
Strength of the bond, okay. Oh. So we'll see then what exactly is bond energy. You are all very close to the right answer. Okay. So bond energy is nothing but it is a amount of energy. Okay. So I can take it as total amount of energy which is going to be released Okay, the total amount of energy is going to be released when one mole of bonds of same type are formed. Same type or different type, we can take, no problem. Are formed is said to be bond energy. So bond energy is nothing but total amount of energy which is released when say one mole of bonds of same type of different type are formed is called bond energy. For example, if I have atom A and atom B. I have these two atoms and Okay, so if I have two atoms A and B, okay, so here when this forms a bond with this, okay, when A forms a bond or B forms a bond, whatever, when these forms, there is a small amount of energy is going to be released here during this. Andre yavade ondu bond formation agbekadre when they combine, they are going to release some amount of energy. Aa energy en release agutte, that we call it as a bond energy. Got it? What is bond energy? Did you got it? What I say, what do you mean by bond energy?
No.
So bond energy is nothing but amount of energy released when they form the bond. Okay. Bond formation agbekar energy is release agutte anta. Yakandre we all know that if you have any two bodies, those two bodies will have some amount of energy. Andre, for example, I can take it as this is in the unstable state. Okay. So this is in the unstable state. Unstable anta yavaga heltivi, so when they are more reactive, okay, so more reactive and more energy irutte. So avaga when they combine, then the whatever the more energy in it, extra energy in it, ad release aagu. So that's going to release, and that energy which is released is said to be bond energy. Okay, when that energy which is in excess is released, then at that time they are going to be stable. So yavaga stable agutte andre when they form the bond, then they are going to be stable here. Okay, so by releasing the energy they become stable. Is that clear now? Bond energy.
It's
okay, so now can you tell me what type of reaction is this bond energy? Whether it is going to be endo or whether it is going to be exo?
Exothermic.
Right? So you can remember that one. Whenever the bond formation takes place, all that going to release the energy. Right? So in general, what I can remember is chemical bond formation is always exothermic. Okay? Chemical bond formation is always exothermic. Is that clear? I hope it's clear. But when you don't answer to me, then I only need to take the answer. So next we'll see bond type.
Gukko pote kabura.
And
kya? What do you think?
Bond character. Bond type and bond character. ಬಾಂಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ನ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಟೂ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಡಯಾಟಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್, ವಿ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಯಾಟಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್, may or may not have a same electronegativity. When two atoms are bonded in a diatomic molecule, So they have they have or they may not have same electronegativity. So hope you know what is electronegativity, right? Do people know what is electronegativity?
Sir, no.
No, okay. So when two atoms are bonded, they may have same electronegativity. Andre erdu atom A matte B idre avu erdukku same electronegativity irbodu. Athava they may not have same electronegativity difference. Okay, so here an electronegativity. So measure of an atom's ability to attract the electron. That is what electronegativity. So it has to have a tendency to attract shared pair of electrons towards itself. So if you see the electronegativity trend in the periodic table, electronegativity increases across the period. That means if I am moving from hydrogen to up to helium, I'll not consider here a noble gas. I'll not consider noble gas because we know that it is going to be very stable. So we'll not consider, only up to fluorine will be taking. Okay, so up to 17 group only we'll consider. So if I going from hydrogen to fluorine, what happens to the electronegativity? Electronegativity is going to be high. And you know which is the most electronegative element here is going to be fluorine. Right, so fluorine is going to be most highly electronegative. And what happens to, does it down the group? Is down the group, it is going to decrease. This so one more down the group, so down the group it is going to decrease. So it will decrease as we move down the group, but across the period it will increase. So that is what electronegativity is. I'll come to this later. Okay. So, in the first case, we'll consider four different cases here by keeping the electronegativity. So, I have told that when the compounds, when the atoms combine and they form a bond, there might be a difference in electronegativity or may not be a same. So, if I take two elements A and B, and if they combine, the electronegativity of element A is A1 and electronegativity of element B is 4. And in other case, so here A is 2.5 and B is 3.0. There's the electronic difference. And if I take A and A, the electronegativity here is less than 1.5. Electronegativity is less than 1.5, and here also electronegativity is less than 1.5. And for B, here the electronegativity is going to be greater than 2 and it is going to be greater than 2. Okay, so it's too high. So nalakku cases tagondidhi. So in the first case, if A and B are two constant atoms combining each other, so if I ask you the what is the electronegativity difference, how much is the electronegativity difference? It is going to be
3,
right? So this electronegativity difference, what we observe, is going to be very huge. So it's going to be huge. Let's come to here. In this case, how much?
0.5.
It is going to be a 0.5. Yes. Definitely. Here in this case?
Zero.
Right? So, same is alva, electron radiative difference. So, same is that you will get obviously that it is zero. And here also, in this case also, I can take it as?
Zero.
Zero. Yes, absolutely. Okay. So, these are the four cases we have. So, now we will see. What if have this much of differences, what the observations are we are going to make with these differences. So in the first case, if electronegativity of atom is less than 1.5. Less than 1.5. You remember this is very important now. If electronegativity of atom is less than 1.5, or it can be also less than 1. You can take it as less than 1 only. Let's take, you can take it in the range of 1 to 1.5. 1 to 1.5 in the kammi bandra electronegativity. Okay, then they come under metals. Then they are going to come under what? Metals. Okay, and the other atom though, electronegativity less than 1 is right. They are going to be big, they are going to be what? They are called as metals. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. No.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. And in similar case, so I'll clear this and take that on last. So in the next case, if the electronegativity is greater than 1.5, greater than 1.5, then this is going to be what?
Non-metal.
So, if the electronegative value is going to be greater than 1.5, then it is going to be non-metal. And we even observe there may be some metals with 1.6 and 1.7 of electronegativity. And in the metals, the electronegativity is less than 1. But there are some metals which shows more than 1.6, 1.7 electronegativity. Such kind of elements are not going to be metals. They behave as a metalloids. Okay. So, some of them are going to be behaving as a metalloid. So, they will be having both the characters. So, that is why their electronegativity ranges between above 1.6 and 1.7. So, after kelondu na observe martivi adrella metalloids agirthare. But pure metal anta bandre avurdu electronegativity avuttu less than 1 irutte. Okay. So now I can observe here, in the case of yes,
is there any specific electronegativity for metalloids?
That metalloids electronegativity ranges between metal and non-metal ratio. See, like if I take metals is 1 and non-metal is going to be above than 1.5, more than 1.5. It means it extends to up to 4, because the most electronegative element has an electronegativity of only 4. So I can take it as between 1.5 to 3.9. Okay. So there might be mixture of metals and non-metals as well. So it's going to be a little more difficult to have a range of them. So hardly it will be around 1.6 to 1.8 range. Within this it is going to be metalloids, because they exhibit both characters. So the range is going to be slightly 1.6 to 1.8. It is not an exact range, because we cannot differentiate for that, because some cases they show the metallic character and some cases they are going to show the non-metallic character. And their electronegativity value cannot be given in a constant terms. If I give also 1.7 or 1.8, it obviously should be a non-metal. But it cannot be acting as a non-metals all the time, and it cannot be acting as a metals all the time. In some cases, it will change. So for that reason, we don't have a particular range for the metalloids. So we have a range for metal and non-metal. So we'll come back to this. Here I can see the element A has an electronegativity of 1, which means whether this is a metal or non-metal.
Metal.
Metal.
Right? Metal. So this is going to be metal. And what about B?
Non-metal.
Non-metal.
Yes. So now I got to know. There is a metal A and there is a non-metal B, and therefore the force of attraction between them is going to be which type of bond?
Ionic bond.
Covalent bond. Ionic bond.
Ionic bond.
It is going to be ionic bond. So what my conclusion or what my observation over this is, hence I can tell that if the difference in electronegativity of two element exceeds the difference in electronegativity of two element exceeds 1.7 ಗಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ಎರಡು ಆಟಮ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಆಟಮ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ 1.7 ಗಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬಂದ್ರೆ then the nature of bond is going to be ionic. Are you getting what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
So electronegativity difference nimge 1.7 ginta jaasti bandre avaga aa type of bond enagirutade ionic bond agirutade. Then the nature of bond is going to be ionic. So we have to remember here that case 1.7. So we'll move on to the next one. So now A is going to be 2.5, which is a non-metal, and B is again
non-metal.
So now you know what kind of bonding here possible. Going to be
covalent bond.
Okay. So we can see the difference is 0.5, right?
Yes, sir.
Which is less than 1.7. So now difference in electronegativity is less than 1.7. Adra ena agutte?
Covalent bond.
Then the nature of bond is going to be covalent. So that we have to remember now. If the electronegativity difference is less than 1.7. Then it is covalent. So I can write like this. So if it exceeds, this is ionic. If it is going to be less,
covalent bond.
Covalent. Okay. So this is the electronegativity difference. Here I can write it as the electronegativity difference. So the covalent and the ionic. Here it is. So 1.7 is the midpoint here. More than 1.7 is ionic, less than 9.7 is covalent. Is that clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll come back to the third concept, our third case. So in that case, we can see two same atoms, right? You don't have a different atom here. You have a same atoms. And the electronegativity difference is almost zero. Very close to zero, I can call it as very close to zero. Okay, we'll see this one now. So whether A is a metal or non-metal now?
No, it's a metalloid.
I can take it as a metal because it is less than 1.5, right? Metalloid should be more than 1.5. Is that clear? Getting it? So this is also metal and this is also metal. So therefore, what kind of bond it can form?
metallic bond.
Metallic bond. It will form metallic bond. So now what can I tell? If the difference approaches to zero or close to zero, okay, if the electromagnetic difference approaches to zero or close to zero, then it is going to be form what kind of bond?
Metallic bond.
Provided whatever the atom what we have taken should okay. I think some network issue was there. Zoom got reloaded. Okay. So here I was saying about A and A. So where the electronegative difference was less than 1.5 in both the cases. Okay. So in this case, both are going to be metal. So then the force of attraction or the bond type of bond is going to be metallic bond. And the difference between the electronegative atoms is going to be zero. So provided if the two atoms are going to be in the metallic state, then there exists a metallic bond. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, if I take B and B, here I told it is going to be 2 and greater than 2. So then it is going to be which type of element? Is it metal, non-metal or?
Non-metal.
Yes, so both are going to be non-metal. Alva, eradu kuda non-metal agirutade. So ivereddu madhyano difference eno?
Zero.
Agare idenu covalent bond agutta idu? Non-metal alva? Can call them as a covalent bond? Right or wrong?
Correct, no?
Okay. So already one covalent bond one time. This is the second time covalent bond is coming, right?
Yes, sir. No?
So in the first case, in observed, if the difference is less than 1.7, and the difference is equal to 0 or almost 0. So Andre, we got two types of covalent bond here. So eradu reetiyada covalent bartha ide namge. So how we are going to differentiate this one? How we can differentiate this one? So I'll show the both the cases now. So as I told, one case A and this is B. One is metal and both are non-metal. Here you have two different atoms. Remember, you have two same atoms. Okay. So here in this case, what I told is the difference in electronegativity is less than 1.7. Right? Difference in electronegativity is less than 1.5 and is not equal to zero. Is that clear? Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So this will be less than 1.7 and it is not equal to zero. At this case, the covalent bond what is arising is said to be polar covalent bond. It's very important. Okay, so when the electronegativity difference is less than 1.7 but it is not equal to zero, then we say it is going to be polar covalent bond. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Second case, here it is a covalent bond, but the electronegativity difference here is going to be equal to zero. Then we say this as non-polar covalent bond. Understand the difference now. less than 1.7 and not equal to 0, but it is equal to 0. Both the cases different. So yavaga polar covalent bond agutte yavaga non polar covalent bond agutte. Got to know now? Is that got the idea? What is polar and what is non-polar? But I will be explaining more of that later classes. And I will give the examples as well for that. So we will get to know the clear picture. But as for now, what is polar covalent bond? Electronegativity difference mele now 1.7 kammi matte not equal to 0 agirbeku. And two different atoms will be here. And when it comes to non-polar covalent atom, electronegativity difference is going to be equal to 0 and they will have the same. Is that clear up here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll stop at this point and let us discuss about the remaining in the next class. Okay. Is that clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And since Saturday, we had planned to have the test, and on occasion of Independence Day, we are giving freedom, I guess. I'm not sure about that. If there is, I don't think 90% or 95% of thing, there will not be any test for you people tomorrow. Okay. So, and I'll be discussing about that, or I'll ask my team to give me a clear picture of that. And once we get to know, we'll be sending that across your groups. And hopefully there will be no test. And I'll make sure that they'll not conduct any tests tomorrow. Okay. So if you people want to write the test, you can tell me. You want to write or don't want? So Afia says, so please don't want the test. You want freedom, he's saying. Okay, Afia, sure, you'll get the freedom, definitely. Okay. So anyways, advance, happy independence wishes to you all.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Wish you the same.
Okay, thank you all. So I'll stop at this point. I'll if anything is there, I'll discuss
thank you. In the next
class. Okay, so thank you all. Have a good
Thank you.